हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। मैं रामपाल प्रजापत फ्रॉम इलेक्ट्रिकल डिपार्टमेंट। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन आवर टुडे क्लास वी विल डिस्कस ऑन सर्किट एनालिसिस पार्ट 18। एंड फॉर टुडे क्लास आवर टॉपिक इज इनवर्स लाप्लास ट्रांसफॉर्म एंड एप्लीकेशन ऑफ लाप्लास ट्रांसफॉर्म। In our previous class, we have discussed about Laplace transform. So first we discuss about definition of Laplace transforms and some its formulas. In previous class, we have discussed that Laplace transform is the method of conversion a time domain response into frequency domain. Now, let us consider a function f(t) and its Laplace is fs. A Laplace transform of function f(t) is obtained in such a manner that 0 to integration of function e to the power minus st f(t) dot dt limit 0 to infinite. This is the procedure of finding Laplace of any function. Let me take an example to find Laplace transform. First is Laplace transform of function ut, where ut is a unit step function. So its Laplace transform we have obtained our previous class, that is 1 upon s. So we prove this 0 to infinite integration e to the power minus st dot ut into dt. Simply integration 0 to infinite e to the power minus st. Ut means unit step function and its magnitude is 1, so it is 1 dot dt. Now we apply limit from 0 to infinite, and Laplace integration of function e to the power minus st is e to the power minus st upon minus s. Now we apply limit 0 to infinite e to the power minus infinite upon minus s minus e to the power 0 upon minus s. We know that e to the power minus infinite is equal to 0 and e to the power 0 is equal to 1. So Laplace of function ut is 1 upon s. We place this limit in this equation, then we find Laplace of ut is equal to 1 upon s. Similarly, there are another functions such as Laplace of function e to the power minus at is 1 upon s, and Laplace of function sine hyperbolic at is a upon s square minus a square, and Laplace transform of cos hyperbolic at is s upon s square minus a square. Laplace transform of sin at is a upon s square plus a square, and Laplace transform of cos at is s upon s square plus a square. And Laplace of transform of function t to the power n is factorial n upon s to the power n plus 1. So these all Laplace transform have been discussed in our previous class. So in our today class, we start a new topic, that is inverse Laplace. What is inverse Laplace? Inverse Laplace transform is the method of conversion a frequency domain function or frequency domain response into a time domain response. Means it is inverse of Laplace transform, due to which it is known as inverse Laplace transform. Now if a function is fs, then its inverse Laplace is ft. Now we take an example. Take an inverse Laplace of function एफ एस इज इक्वल टू वन अपॉन एस प्लस वन एस प्लस टू एंड एस. सो प्रोसीजर इज फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल होल फंक्शन इज डिवाइडेड इंटू फ्रैक्शंस. सो वी टेक थ्री फ्रैक्शन दैट इज ए अपॉन एस प्लस वन प्लस बी अपॉन एस प्लस टू प्लस सी अपॉन एस. These fractions are equate with fs that is equal to s plus 1, s plus 2 and s. Now equating these equation and if we want to find the value of a, then we put s is equal to minus 1. When we put s is equal to minus 1 in this equation, then we obtain a is equal to minus 1. And if we put s is equal to minus 2, we obtain b is equal to 1 by 2. And if we put s is equal to 0, then we find c is equal to 1 by half. Now we put the value of a, b and c in the fractions of function fs and we take inverse Laplace that is equal to minus 1 upon s plus 1, 1 by half s plus 2, 1 by half s. In our previous class we know that the Laplace transform of function e key power minus t is 1 upon s plus 1. So directly we can write inverse Laplace of 1 upon s plus 1 is e key power minus t and inverse Laplace of function s plus 2 is e key power minus 2 and inverse Laplace of function 1 upon s is 1. So this is the procedure of finding inverse Laplace transform of any function fs. Next is convolution theorem. Convolution theorem states that if Laplace transform of function fs is ft and Laplace transform of function gs is gt, then complete Laplace inverse of function fs dot gs will be integration 0 to t fu dot gt minus u, that is ft dot gt. This is the convolution theorem. Now we take an example to understand this theorem. In this example, take inverse Laplace of function 1 upon s square cos s minus 1. Here we divide this function into two functions. One is fs, that is 1 upon s square, and gs is 1 upon s minus 1. So according to convolution theorem, Laplace inverse of complete function 1 upon s square cos 1 s minus 1 is equal to Laplace inverse of 1 upon s square dot 1 upon s minus 1, or Laplace inverse of 1 upon s square cos s minus 1 is equal to 0 to t u e key power t minus u dot du. So simply e key power t is free from u, so it is a constant. We can place it from out from integration part. So e key power t integration 0 to t u e key power minus u dot du. So simply e key power t and integration of u dot e key power minus u is minus u e key power minus u minus e key power minus u. So apply limit 0 to t, we obtain e key power minus t minus t plus 1. So this is the procedure of finding Laplace inverse of two functions fs and gs, that is ft dot gt. Now next is time displacement theorem. What is time displacement theorem? According to this theorem, if a function ft be and Laplace transformable, and if Laplace transform of function ft is fs, then Laplace transform of function ft minus capital T should be e to power minus ft dot fs, where function ft minus capital T is the function ft which is displaced by t. So by this theorem, the displacement in time domain becomes multiplication by e to power minus ft in s domain. This is the statement of time displacement theorem. Simply, if a function displaces in time by t, then in s domain it is multiplication of e to power minus ft dot fs. Now proof of this theorem is, if Laplace transform of function ft minus a is equal to 0 to infinite integration e to power minus ft ft minus a dot dt, let t minus a is equal to u, then dt is equal to du. So we place small t is equal to capital T plus u. So integration 0 to infinite e to power minus s cos t plus u fu dot du. Next, integration 0 to infinite e to power minus s t e to power minus su fu dot du. E to power minus st is free from u, so this is a constant and we can write it out from integration part. So e to power minus st integration of 0 to infinite e to power minus su fu dot du fu dot du. We know that integration 0 to infinite e to power minus st fu dot du is equal to fs. So Laplace of function function ft minus capital T is e to power minus st dot fs. This is the proof of time displacement theorem. Now we take example. In this given example, function ft is ut minus a, means ft is displaced in time domain by a, then obtain its Laplace transform. Now we simply change limit from a to infinite ft e to power minus st dot dt. Ft is considered, ft is ut, that is unity step function, and its value is 1. So integration 0 to integration a to infinite e to power minus ft dot dt. We know that integration of e to power minus ft is e to power minus ft upon minus s. Now apply limit a to infinite, then we obtain Laplace of ut minus a is equal to e to power minus as cos 1 upon s. This proves the time displacement theorem. Next is initial value theorem. What is initial value theorem? This theorem is used to find the initial value of function in both time domain and S domain or frequency domain. So, explanation of initial value theorem is, The direct Laplace transform of the derivative of function f(t), that is dft upon dt with limit s tends to infinite give limit s tends to infinite Laplace of derivative function dft upon dt is limit s tends to infinite 0 to infinite dft upon dt e to power minus at dot dt. So simply limit s tends to infinite sfs minus f0 plus, where with s tends to infinite e to power minus st 0. So limit s tends to infinite sfs minus f0 plus is equal to 0. Since f0 is a constant, so f0 plus is equal to limit s tends to infinite s of fs, where f0 indicates the initial value of function fs in s domain that can be found applying limit s tends to infinite sfs. It means this equation permits the evaluation of the initial value of time domain solution ft. It is then possible to work directly with the transform version of the solution to obtain initial values by performing the operation called for on the right hand side of equation. Equation can be stated as initial value theorem. Now we take an example. If a function fs is 2 upon s minus 1 upon s plus 3, and we have to find initial value of this function. Now according to initial value theorem, we apply limit s tends to infinite function s dot fs. So we multiply function fs with s. So 2s upon s minus s upon s plus 3. S to s cancel. Now we find limit s tends to infinite 2 minus 1 upon 1 plus 3 upon s. So we put the value s tends to infinite. Then we find 2 minus 1 upon 1 plus 3 upon infinite. We know that 1 upon infinite is equal to 0. So term 3 upon infinite is equal to 0. So the initial value is 2 minus 1 upon 1 plus 0, or 2 minus 1 is equal to 1. It means initial value of function fs is equal to 2 upon s minus 1 upon s plus 3 is 1. Next theorem is final value theorem. Final value theorem is used to find the final value of the function. It means it is used to find the steady state value of function in both time and s domain. So simply we take Laplace of derivative function ft upon dt with limit s tends to 0. S tends to 0 means t tends to infinite. So limit s tends to 0, 0 to infinite integration dft upon dt e to power minus st dot dt. So we know that Laplace transform of any derivative function f dash t is equal to fs sfs minus f0, and limit is s tends to 0. But s tends to 0, integration 0 to infinite dft upon dt e to power minus st dot dt, and that is equal to 0 to infinite d of ft, because e to power minus 0 is equal to 1. E to power minus 0 is equal to 1. So we find f infinite minus f0 plus applying limit. However, f0 plus being a constant. So f infinite minus f0 is equal to minus f0 plus limit s tends to 0 of sfs. Simply f infinite is equal to limit s tends to 0 s of fs, or limit s tends to 0 sfs is equal to limit t tends to infinite f of t. Means this equation represents the final value theorem. In the final value theorem, it is useful where the transformed solution of problem is available and the needed information is about the final or steady state solution. So if we have to find the final value or steady state value of any function fs which is in s domain, then we apply limit s tends to 0 and s of fs. So we in this example, a function is given fs that is equal to 2 upon s minus 1 upon s plus 3, and we have to find final value of this function. So according to final value theorem, final value of function in s domain is limit s tends to 0 with function s fs, or in time domain we can write t tends to infinite with function f of t. So s fs is 2 minus s upon s plus 3, means function fs is multiplied with s, then we obtain 2 minus s upon s plus 3. So limit s tends to 0, so sfs is 2 because this term is 0. When we put s is equal to 0, then second term is 0 and the value of function sfs is 2 at s tends to 0. It means the value of function fs at t tends to infinite or s tends to 0 is 2. Means final value of function fs is 2. That is the steady state value of this function. Thank you for today class, dear students. So in this lecture, we have discussed about inverse Laplace transform, which is the inverse of Laplace transform. Means it is the method of conversion a frequency domain response into time domain. And there are some theorems such as convolution theorem, time shifting theorem, initial value theorem and final value theorem. So we have discussed in this lecture these all theorems. So dear students, in next class our topic will be on pole zero or transfer function. We will discuss on transfer functions. Transfer function simply is the ratio of Laplace transform of output to the Laplace transform of input. Now deep discussion will be done in next class. So thank you for today class.